Welcome to Drinking Bros, presented by GhostBed.com.
There's a couple getting wedding photos. They're about to throw leaves in the air. Shoot it, Alec. Get a shot of that. We're gonna put this up on YouTube. This is what happens, dude, when you take wedding photos. They make you do like the things that you don't want to do in this life. And Jesse, stop looking at them. Come on. You're giving it away. We're not supposed to be looking at them throwing the leaves. They're about to throw the leaves. Let them throw the leaves, Jesse. Let them throw the leaves. Look at that.
There's also somebody doing aggressive push-ups over here.
So, yeah, well, I don't mind
what is,
that.
What
oh,
is
my
he?
God. That guy's fucking the ground right now. Wow, this is really weird. So,
here's
the thing whenever I see these family photos or wedding photos. Yeah. This is a God's honest truth. I think about how fucking miserable the guy is every single time.
Yeah, we put up with a lot. I know you guys, like, have kids for us and raise them and shit.
Yeah.
But having to stand outside for 45 minutes to get pictures taken is way worse than that. Like, all you do is make a baby with your body, carry it around for 9 months, shit it out, and then feed it from your body for another 6 months. That's not a big deal.
Yeah, well, look.
That's exactly how having a baby works. No, I
can't hear you on camera, Jesse. So.
She doesn't agree with my biological
information. Here's the thing. Women are vessels for us. Like, it's pretty much the men that does everything when having a baby. But I look at these photos. A friend of mine just took these fucking photos, by the way.
Yeah.
With his wife. And it wasn't for their wedding. Like, they're already married. And they were doing, like, those type of, like, oh, we're by a lake and all that shit photos. I felt so sorry for him that I wanted to reach out and say, oh, my God. Your smile in those photos...
It's fake,
and you hate every fucking second of this.
I'm okay with being a good Instagram husband. Are you familiar with that term?
Yeah.
So for those of you who don't know, that means your girl wants to get cool pictures next to whatever and some weird poses she can't get by herself, so you take the pictures for her and then show her, and she doesn't like it, and you do that 70 times until she gets one picture that works.
Yeah.
I'm fine with that. Because I'm actually doing something. I'm just standing there like a jackass on my... Like Ricky Bobby, I don't know what to do with my hands.
I'm fine with that. When you hire a professional photographer to go and take shots of the two of you,
yeah.
Somebody asked for that symposium we spoke at a few weeks ago. They were like, I don't understand why this photo. I was like, I don't have any photos of myself.
Yeah.
I don't want to hire a photographer for me to fucking put a button down on and pretend like I care.
No, it's weird to me.
Super like, weird, right?
What's the real point? I mean, if it's for posterity and shit, what's the point of capturing staged moments?
That's what I don't
understand. Pull out your phone when something cool's happened. Because we can do that now.
Yeah.
Take a picture, like grab your fucking wife by the shoulder and fucking take a selfie of yourself, and that'll be there forever.
Same thing with concerts, right? I don't mind. You want to pop off like 30 seconds of a song, a few pictures or whatever, right? I don't get people who
record the whole goddamn thing.
Record a whole fucking concert. Yeah. It's like, dude. You're watching the concert.
Yeah, you can go on YouTube and watch a much more better quality.
Better quality
fucking,
than off your phone.
Yeah.
And I told a woman that at a show one time.
Yeah.
I said, hey, it was like 8 minutes, right? I think it was 8:38 was the exact time code of how long she was filming this concert. And I go, are you going to shoot the whole entire thing? And she kind of looked at me and she was like, me? And I was like, yeah. I was like, you're past the 8 minute mark at this point. I go, just out of curiosity, what are you going to do with that? She was like, I don't know. I'm gonna watch it later.
Nope.
And I was like, are you? Do you think you'll watch it later? And she was like, well, I might upload it to YouTube. And I was like, great. But then are you gonna watch that video? Or is that for someone else? I go, were you hired by someone else? And she got real like, oh my God, you're right. This is really dumb. Why am I doing this? Because if you really think about why you're filming for that long at a concert, you're just like,
that's one of a concert. That's one of a number of things that we should just cancel on the internet. Like, nobody needs to see that. Nobody needs to see, unless you're at some crazy restaurant. Like, if you go to Sobelman's in Milwaukee and get one of those Bloody Marys that has a whole fried fucking chicken on top of it, take a picture of that. But if you just got a plate of biscuits and gravy, nobody cares about that shit, dude. Come on, man. And if you're not in a fucking like Michelin-starred restaurant or something, or a James Beard Award-winning restaurant, don't take pictures of your food.
I have not. I don't think I've ever taken a picture of my food.
I have, for sure.
If it's cool.
Food I've made myself.
If it's gone.
Or if it's cool, yeah.
You're right. If it's some shocking thing with like a duck's head on top of it, right?
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, fuck, that's amazing. Other than that, look, a steak is a steak, you know? Like, I look at Rogan's Instagram. It's just elk meat and jalapenos. And I look, I'm saying this as a Joe Rogan fan.
Yeah.
However, his Instagram is simply just pictures of his dog and elk meat and jalapenos.
Yeah, it's weird.
It's strange.
But he doesn't care about social media.
No, I know. But he clearly cares enough to take a picture of his food and share it. And besides him, I don't have many people in my life. They're the best food Instagram. There's only one you really need to go to. It's actually Grill Your Ass Off.
Yeah, they're pretty good.
They have the best food Instagram I've seen of, like, meats and all that other shit. But as far as, like, stranger, like, friends and things like that taking pictures of their food, I'm like, God damn it, man. I had a girl who was my assistant in New York for my MTV show. And I still follow her to this day. She takes pictures of her fucking food all the time.
Yeah.
And sometimes it's just, like, Shake Shack.
If you're, like, there are people, a lot of people don't know this in the regular world, but there are people who work in Hollywood and other production areas, and their job, it's called a food stylist.
Yeah.
And they literally come on set. If you have food, if it's like a big Hollywood movie, or even small ones, and there's like a Thanksgiving dinner or something, they arrange everything on that table to make it look right. Or if it's a commercial or something like that and you want the food to look good, they know how to present it and all this other bullshit. That is a real job. If that is your job, then post that picture every single fucking day.
Yeah.
But
if not, don't do it.
Oh, boy.
There's that gay guy who was with the Kardashians forever, Jonathan. I forget his last name, right? I didn't know what he really did. Like, he was kind of like a hairstylist. Jesse always watches that shit. So, like, the Kardashians is on all the time. You know, whenever I get home, I see a Kardashian thing in the background or a fucking Real Housewives thing, and I'm just like,
whoop.
Sports.
Keep on walking.
Sports or nothing. I'm getting the fuck out of here.
What?
Or news. Like, I'd rather watch news or something, right? So, anyways, this guy who I've seen off and on for years of my life at this point, because the Kardashians have been on for 15 years, I think. He was like a gay guy, and I couldn't tell if he was trying to fuck Kim or I didn't know what the deal was, right? And I think he was initially a hairdresser. He reinvented himself, if you will, as a character called the Food God on Instagram, and it's just him eating food everywhere. And I'm like, what?
Is it interesting?
He has like fucking 2 million followers. No, it's just him eating food in different places. But it's like he's a thinner kind of gay guy. And
have you seen the ASMR stuff?
Yes.
Like, a lot of Asian people have full YouTube and Instagram channels, and it's nothing but them with some shotgun mic or some like super or hypercardioid mic near their face.
Yeah.
And they're just eating. And it's the noise. It's supposed to be. I don't know what
can
the fuck
get
it
off
is,
from
dude.
That?
I don't know what people do with it, honestly. I don't know. I haven't looked into it enough. Is it a sexual thing, or is it just like something weird that people enjoy?
I don't know.
Is it like listening,
it's got to be sexual.
Is it like listening to the ocean and it calms you down or some shit? I don't know.
I don't understand it.
To me, it's weird as shit.
It's like the fucking food god. Here's the thing, last bit on this food god thing, right? Anybody who wants to pretend that they're a foodie,
yeah.
I'm a foodie. So is everybody, motherfucker. Everybody wants to eat. I don't know anybody who hates good food.
Yeah, you breathe a lot too. Are you an airy? Shut the fuck up, asshole.
And with that, if you are the food god, I want to see you fat as fuck, like Guy Fieri, right?
Yeah, or the
if
guy
I'm watching a cooking show.
Yeah, yeah.
I want to see him fatter than shit. Then I know they're really eating this.
Or
food.
The dude from Man vs. Food after 3 seasons, he had to stop because he was eating so much.
Yeah, he quit.
Like he quit because he was gonna die.
And they had to get another dude in there.
Yeah. You know who I'd like to see? What's his name? Andy
Dick?
The guy from. The guy from Firefest. What's his name?
Oh, that guy, yeah. So he's getting a show, by the
way. So I want him to have a cooking show, but really it just turns into him making drinks and getting fucked up.
So
that's what I would like to see.
You're close. He's going to go. They're shooting a reality show of him right now. Andy King is his name.
Andy King, yeah. Hey, do you see these people doing these weird things in the background?
Oh, yeah, just casually get them.
Yeah.
Subscribe to our channel on YouTube. This is a bonus episode. You'll literally see what we're talking. We just drove by the park and we're like, fuck it, let's pop up here because there's all these fucking weird people doing shit.
I kind of think this guy might be into it.
I think he
is
too.
Look at this.
No. Do you see that, Alec?
These are going to look great on Instagrams.
Fuck, dude.
It's kind of upsetting me, to be honest.
I think, here's the thing, because I'm married, you're not. The reason why I'm not shitting on that fact. Maybe you're doing it right and I'm wrong. Who knows? When you're right, like this moment right here, right before you get married, you're willing to do dumb shit like this.
Yeah.
And then after you get married, you're like, fuck no, we're not.
I feel
that.
Like I would be more prone to do it after, to be honest. Like when I know that I've we talk a lot of shit on this show, but when I'm in, I'm all in, dude.
Yeah.
Like, I'm super into the fucking, you've seen me with a girl before.
Yeah.
Like, I'm super into it. I think I would probably be into it more afterwards than before.
Okay.
Like, the honeymoon phase to me, you know how my robot brain works. I'm like, this is all just, like, bullshit right now.
Right.
Like, yeah, it's great, but, like, this isn't the real thing yet. That's why, like, if I was going to start dating a new woman, like, hey, what do you want to go do? You know what I want to do? I want to go to a fucking grocery store and buy groceries with you. Like, honestly, let's go shopping for fucking school supplies, because that's what our life is. It's not going to fucking movies and dinners and shit. Our life is doing stupid bullshit like that all the time. I need to see if we can be in that environment and tolerate and still love each other, because if not, then what the fuck's the point of all this shit?
Maybe you should start with that. Lead off in these relationships with that, of like, hey, I'm not going to take you to a nice steakhouse tonight. You know what I'm going to take you to?
Yeah.
I'm gonna take you right on down to Target, and like a super Target, one of the big ones, and say, hey,
we're both gonna do each of our shopping for the whole week together.
Yes, we'll be here for 2 hours.
Yeah,
and then let's see if we don't kill each other.
Or take them to IKEA.
And I was just gonna say, then go to IKEA right afterwards, and then go home for the next 7 hours. Set up that table that's gonna be in your office.
Ooh, shit! Can you imagine that being a first date, building IKEA furniture together?
That should be mandatory for everyone.
That'd be the test right there. We've got to get Jared to do this.
Or if you're like right before you're gonna get married, you should just say, hey, all right, cool. Let's see how compatible we really are. Go to IKEA and pick out 4 items.
Yeah,
and just spend Saturday and Sunday putting those together.
Yeah.
If you don't want to fucking murk the other person by the end of it,
yeah,
then you, congratulations, you get a marriage license.
Yep.
There should be somebody in the room that watches it and is like, all right, yeah, I'm here the whole time, and I will give you this marriage license because I think you're going to work.
Attorneys would never allow that to happen because they make too much money off divorces.